Hello everyone and welcome. Originally, this was planned to be a quick video to answer a few questions, but a lot of people have been messaging me on Twitter, Instagram, and our Discord server, some excited and some confused on the release date, which a lot of online retailers have for Breath of the Wild 2, and we may have an idea of what to expect for its pre-order bonuses and collector editions. Before we begin, if you could please give this video a like and subscribe, it would help us out a lot. We also have a very special episode of our podcast, the Hylian Gamescast, coming up with our friend Joe returning again to discuss his time working on Breath of the Wild, Age of Calamity, and other games, anime, and projects he wants to tell us about. Comment some questions or topics you would like us to ask Joe, and you'll receive a shout-out when Joe answers your question or discusses your topic. So to begin, Best Buy has a release date for March 3rd, 2022. Amazon has a release date for December 31st, 2022. I'm sure other websites have their own release dates as well, but most should say TBA for to be announced. A lot of people have gotten really excited and messaged me wanting me to cover the leaked release date for Breath of the Wild sequel, and yes, having it officially release on March 3rd, 2022, the 5-year anniversary of the first game, and about 2 years after the prequel spin-off, Age of Calamity, it seems like it would be perfect. Others have been upset or let down they need to wait over an entire year for the end of December 2022, basically only being able to play it after 2023. I have been doing my best to reply and explain the release date situations to everyone who has asked or sent screenshots, and was then asked to make a video explaining it for everyone else who may be confused or not understand what's going on. First, yes, it will be an official pre-order with that retailer. However, it can end up really, really bad for you, which we will get to in just a second. The release date is simply a placeholder. The retailer will usually know the year a game is to be released, and in this case, not the month. So they will set the game's release date as releasing on or before December 31st of the release year, simply using the very last day of the year. Because obviously, if it is to release in that year, then yes, it will be on or before the last day of that year. This is where it begins to get interesting. If they know the month, but not the day, they will usually use the last day of that month. So it is odd Amazon has it set for March 3rd here. It's very specific, and obviously not the last day of that month, which we would expect. Another interesting thing is that we know Nintendo and Amazon had a big partnership to promote the Zelda series in July, around the same time this listing went up using the March 3rd date, based on the messages and screenshots I've been sent. Though this could just be a coincidence, or it could be another one of Amazon's big leaks. Anyways, these placeholder dates work in the favor of the retailers most of the time, but again, can end up being horrible for customers. When Nintendo officially gives Breath of the Wild 2 an official title, release date, description, box art, and everything else, the retailer can go in and quickly edit and update the placeholder page in just a few minutes, as opposed to creating a brand new page and updating everything as fast as possible, which also gives chances of typos or other mistakes, which we have seen a lot. The best being when they mess up the price or release date and you get a game or another item a lot cheaper than the retail price and receive it before its actual release date. Concerning all of this, let's not forget all of the different versions of collector editions and the many different pre-order bonuses. Now, starting with the bad for the customers before the good. A lot of retailers, especially smaller ones, will lock you into your pre-order. So when you pre-order on one of these websites, you are soon charged and only receive exactly what you pre-order. In this case, only the game. This is especially bad if collector's editions, pre-order bonuses, or other things are announced, which you will miss out on, as some retailers will just say you pre-ordered before those items were available, so you don't qualify for them. You may think, oh, well, I'll just refund my money and pre-order again to receive the bonuses. But by the time they end up telling you that you don't receive the pre-order bonuses, they're all already sold out. However, some retailers will be nice and upgrade your pre-order to allow the bonus items you deserve, such as GameStop, Walmart, and other retailers. In other situations, you will have paid your $60 for the standard game and miss out on ordering one of the many different collector's editions, and again, yes, Breath of the Wild 2 will have many, which we will get to after the good parts, if you can call it that. This is all to benefit the retailer. but does give some fans a chance to pre-order and secure a copy before the official pre-orders are announced and sell out. For the company, it means, since their website may be one of the first to allow pre-orders or the game to be purchased, with so many people visiting the placeholder page, even long before official pre-orders begin, not only does it mean they can begin making money for a product they have no idea what the title will be or the release date will be, but because all of the traffic to the site, when the official pre-orders do begin, they will already be listed first on search results, literally meaning millions of dollars in profit that could have gone to other sites. And with them quickly updating the placeholder page, it means they will also have all of the correct information and proper listings before other websites, which have to create theirs from nothing. Now, why am I so sure we will be getting mini bonuses and special editions? If we look at all of the recent Zelda releases, even going all the way back to the Wind Waker, they have all had the standard versions and a more expensive collector's edition, if not just getting the pre-order bonus with the standard edition. In Breath of the Wild's case, it had many different amazing bonuses, unique to each collector's edition as well as different stores and countries, all of which also came with pre-order bonuses on top of everything else. You may be thinking, of course it did. It's Breath of the Wild, the best-selling Zelda game and one of the best-selling Nintendo Switch games of all time, not to mention the insane amount of hype from fans before release. So yes, it would have had a lot. However, that isn't always the case. Before Breath of the Wild, Twilight Princess was the best-selling Zelda game with around 7 million sales, a far cry from Breath of the Wild's 27 million or more. Before Twilight Princess, Wind Waker had a lot of hype around it as well. Despite the outspoken hate for the Toon art style, fans were still overly excited for a next-gen Zelda game following up the legendary Ocarina of Time and Majora's Mask. Plus, the pre-order for Wind Waker just happened to be two different versions of one of the last Zelda games to release, giving us Ocarina of Time and Master Quest, which was based off of the Ura expansion so many fans wanted, and they were free. That would be like buying Breath of the Wild 2 and getting Breath of the Wild free, or buying Breath of the Wild and getting Skyward Sword HD free. Yet, it sold so few copies, even the spin-off Link's Crossbow Training outsold it. Yes. Then we have Skyward Sword, which Nintendo thought would be more successful than Twilight Princess, thanks to around 100 million or more Nintendo Wiis being sold at the time. Yet, a lot of people consider it a financial failure for Nintendo. Years of trying to perfect its motion controls for it to be the biggest complaint from fans. And yes, Skyward Sword also had an insane amount of hype behind it before release. After all, it was the follow-up to the most successful Zelda game of all time, Twilight Princess. Then we had the HD remakes, which honestly didn't sell that well for Wii U either. Despite that, still had collector editions and bonuses. Wind Waker HD had the only Wii U Collector's Edition console and sold with Hyrule Historia downloaded on it, and some versions of the game even came with a Ganondorf statue. Twilight Princess HD only had editions sell with Wolf Link. So despite not amazing sales and the recent pattern, hype isn't everything. After all, this is where the term overhyped comes from. So Breath of the Wild's success wasn't a sure thing at the time, yet Nintendo still went all out. Now, with not only its major success, as well as the prequel spin-off Age of Calamity selling better than most traditional mainline Zelda games, and adding in the support many other Switch games have been seeing, it is just common sense at this point for Breath of the Wild 2 to receive multiple collector's editions just as great or better than the first game. I wouldn't be surprised if it also received its own collector's edition OLED console. For an idea of what to expect for Breath of the Wild 2's collector's editions or pre-order bonuses, let's take a look back at what the original received. This is just three of the many different versions of the collector's editions it had. The Master Edition was $130, which came with a copy of the game, a Master Sword statue, a Nintendo Switch Sheikah Slate carrying case, 24-song soundtrack CD, Sheikah Eye collectible coin, Relic of Hyrule, Calamity Ganon tapestry, and Weatherworn map. The $100 Special Edition came with a copy of the game, the Calamity Ganon tapestry, the 24-song soundtrack, the Switch carrying case, and collectible coin. An exclusive only in Japan, converting to around $140, came with a copy of the game, an alternate cover, the same tapestry, the official soundtrack, an amiibo of Link on horseback, a Master Sword statue, and 4 collector postcards. And remember, this was just 3 of the several different versions, and when you pre-ordered them at GameStop, Walmart, or other retailers, usually the individual stores had their own unique pre-order bonuses as well. So if you do pre-order from one of these sites, as we mentioned, it could cause you to miss out on getting some of these amazing pre-order bonuses, or getting a refund in time to purchase one of the collector's editions, unless you just want to go crazy and buy multiple copies. In which case, why would you risk pre-ordering on one of these websites instead of waiting on the official pre-order? Let me know, what do you hope Breath of the Wild 2 includes in its collector editions or pre-order bonuses? Also, don't forget to check out our podcast, the Hylian Gamescast. Again, on our next episode, our friend Joe will be returning for the 4th or 5th time at this point. For those who don't know, he is the voice actor for Daruk and Yunobo in Breath of the Wild and Age of Calamity. And he has a lot of other great roles in some of your favorite anime and other favorite video games. Go ahead and let us know who you would like to see on our podcast as one of our next guests. And comment some questions or topics you would like us to ask Joe. And you'll receive a shout out when Joe answers your question or discusses your topic. And of course, I want to give a huge thank you to all of our Patreon supporters who give us video ideas like this, some of our Zelda theory, top 10 list, and discussion topics that we discuss on our podcast or other videos. If you would like a shout out at the end of all of our videos or the beginning of our podcast, the Hylian Gamescast, as well as any of the other benefits mentioned. So thank you, Jon Snow, Zane, Fran, Wiggly Wiggle, Nod Narb, or Brandon, Sober X, Mr. Monoclad, Metroid, Jen, Super NX, 64, David, Zoe, Natsu, Jesse, Andre Moy, Ashton, Justin, Candy, Chad, BKRS7, Lerulean Sheep, Largnar, Monica, Shadow to Us, Rusty, Lovable Christy, Henry, and of course, Gus. Thank you all so much.